when we deal with the Paul Bernardos of the world, which thank God is a small percentage of the prison population, people who are convicted of first degree murder, the fact that they can get parole hearings every 2 years is really unfair to the families.
Tim Danson, the lawyer for the families of Kristen French and Leslie Mahaffy, the two teenage girls who were kidnapped, tortured, and murdered near St. Catharines in the early 1990s, says the families are dreading the parole hearing for convicted killer Paul Bernardo, set for later this month.
Quite frankly, it's gut-wrenching for them. It's tentatively scheduled for June 22nd. I've made a lot of inquiries with the parole board to make sure that it, in fact, is going to occur on June 22nd. Just to remind everybody that last time for his first parole hearing, he adjourned it at last minute six times.
Unlike Bernardo's first parole hearing in 2018, when the French and Mahaffy families had to sit in a small room in prison with the offender, this time the hearing will be held virtually due to COVID-19. But they will still have to deliver victim impact statements if they want, which is something that is never easy to do.
Danson says at an in-person hearing, the victim's families sit behind the offender, who looks at the parole board panel. But on Zoom video, they will be looking at Bernardo's face.
That may be very difficult for them, and they have to decide whether they then want to do it by telephone rather than by video.
Danson believes Bernardo, who is now 56, has likely not changed in the past 3 years.
It was really a jaw-dropping experience that he talked about his unspeakable crimes that normal people would talk about the weather. And so it wasn't difficult, based on the evidence, for the parole board to find that Paul Bernardo had no insight into the gravity of his offenses.
He and the families are hopeful Bernardo, who has been diagnosed as a psychopath and sexual sadist, will be denied parole again. Catherine McDonald, Global News.